Tonight on Access TV, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Karen Bergreen, Anthony DeVito, Joe Larson, James Smith, and your host, Mark Curry. Gotham Comedy Live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Curry!
All right, thank you very much. Gotham Comedy Live. What's that? Exactly, what is this, ladies? A purse. What do you want? Wait. Why you ladies bring purses for what you never pay for nothing? Am I right, fellas? Women, like, what do you need a purse this big? How far do you live? Look at this big ass purse. You never know, it might be an earthquake. I got a tent and some flares and some water in here. This is a big ass purse, big slave purse. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oprah Winfrey presents the purse. Mama, no! Sissy Tyson, I'ma give you this purse. Like my mama gave me a purse. Danny Glover, you ain't taking no purse. Ladies and these big ass purses. Women, and they, you know, ladies got money, ladies got change. Don't think, I always got change. The bill could be like $43.33. I got 33 cents. They love to pull all kind of shit out. Want some mints? Mm. Got some lotion. Da-da. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to mess with you and your big ass purse. She's a kleptomaniac. I bet she go up here, all the candles and the, you know, the glasses are missing. No, I'm just teasing. That's a great purse. I love that purse. Ladies, how you ladies doing? Ladies doing all right? Ladies! Ladies, you guys go in the bathroom. I don't know what happens. You guys go into the bathroom at night. You look good now, but you go in that bathroom and stay an hour and come back, and my beautiful girl, you come back and look homeless. What the fuck? Before you come out, ladies, look in the mirror, right on the mirror, and say, would I fuck me? And look at yourself. You can't put on no kind of hat. Keep all your makeup on. I can't do it when you ain't got no eyebrows. It throw me off. Yeah, but longer you've been with the woman, the bigger the pajamas get every year. You guys look crazy in your pajamas. We don't tell you because we want to hit it. We just, you look great. Oh my God. MC Hammer? What the fuck? And women be thinking they look good. I shouldn't give you none. I'd be like, I really don't even want it. See, Tiger Woods having problems. See that? Tiger! Tiger, he should have did a Viagra commercial. Hi, I'm Tiger Woods. After I played 13 holes, I played 13 more holes. Tiger milk. I ran into a cowboy today. I love New York, because you never know who you're going to meet on the street. I love him. Hey, how you doing, goddamn boy? How you doing? Arsenio, I love you. Look. God, because you can't fight a cowboy. They don't back down to nobody. It could be, you know, five dudes, one cowboy. Come on, son, bitch, come on. Come on. They say little weird shit. I'll skin you like a snake caught in a tree while fishing off a goddamn finger puff. Come out. What'd he say? I don't know. Let's leave his ass alone. I think Obama got a pistol. Obama got a walk like no other president I've ever seen. You know, all the other presidents get off the plane, walk straight. Even the dog will walk straight, you know. Just... Obama get off, you can tell he got a little pistol. He be throwing his... He got his own swag. He do his own little security, just a little check and shit. All right. He always moving. All right, hey, let's go, Malia. Keep it going. Just in case something happened. You know, he from Chicago. You know he gonna pull something out. I believe America, pop, 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 pop. He ghetto, he probably wouldn't even leave the stage. Fuck you. The president apparently has a pistol. You know, shoot. They start shooting, they may get in the car and drive off. Wouldn't that be wild? I mean, imagine you come to a red light, you see, you know, President Obama just low, mean mugging you just with a CIA hat on, peeking over the seat. Michelle in the back with a shotgun. Rock-a-bye, baby, rock-a-bye. I'm running for president, damn it. Vote for me. I make it illegal not to have a job. You ain't got no job. We got job task force roll up on your ass. You ain't got no job. What's wrong with you? Your back hurt. Well, we gonna put you up in these buses to check for bonds. There's a job for everybody. Let's go. We're gonna do it like this. We're gonna change the whole crime. What you did, the weapon you killed people with, that's what we're gonna to send you back to Iraq with, or whatever war it is. Very, very simple like this. Say you shot somebody. We're gonna give you that same gun. 5 bullets, and we're gonna send you wherever war we at. You like to shoot? Good luck. Let me be the goddamn judge. How you doing? I'm tired. It's too much judge and jury. You stabbed 3 people with a knife. Well, we got that knife and we sharpened it for you, okay? Good luck. You're gonna need it. Where you going? Okay, good luck, motherfucker. I'll be a good ass president. We have a budget. I file chapter 13. Tell the other countries, hey, we can't pay you back right now, sorry. Very simple, little things like that. Condoleezza Rice would be my running mate, be curry and rice. Simple shit. You want an older woman, I love older women. Older women, we love you, thank you. Older women are sexy as hell. I went to older women's strip club. In Atlanta, I swear, they just did like this all night. Like that. That was the most action, double up. They was popping their hip out. Pop out. It was great. I loved it. Older women could be sexy without being sexy. They could say sexy and use fruit.
You know, the bread is in the oven and the butter's warm, huh?
Hello? You don't know if she's talking sex or food.
The peaches are wet. Hello?
She hang up the phone, you feel violated. What happened? Young women, we love you. With my young women, we love you. Clean your butter. Young women, clean your butter. You go to a young woman's house like a plate. They just got a chair and a table. Like the fuck? You about to do a raisin in the sun or what? Young women be having different stuff at their house. We love you, but older women's house is, you know, it's firm. They got drapes, they curtains, they got carpet. Ain't no boxes in the corner. Young women be just having the light, no lampshade, just a light bulb. And after a while, your cornea burning. You trying to sit sideways at an angle. You playing puppet with the... Young women be having, they butter be dirty. Clean your butter, young women. You could do CSA crime unit. You could tell everything she ate that week. That was, she had a bagel here. It must have been Monday then, because you could see the chip. That's a blueberry chip, and that's a waffle, and this is wheat toe. This is a tortilla right here. Okay. We gotta keep the show going. You guys ready to have some fun? That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm talking about. I forgot the camera, man. You scared me. I love your shirt, brother. I love that shirt. That man got a Christmas shirt. That's a nice shirt. Oh, we got 30 seconds. We got to keep moving. Okay, I got to wrap it up. I don't know what that means. Wrap it up. We got to wrap it up. Global warming is happening, people. Global warming.
I don't even know what I'm talking about. But we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Karen Bergreen is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Karen Bergreen, ladies and gentlemen, you see her on Comedy Central.
I think they're really stupid, right? I was in a taxi with them today, and the taxi driver was wearing a turban, and my little one turns to me and he says, "Mama, why is a genie driving the taxi?" And you do things to try to make them more intelligent, right? We've got the shower curtain with the periodic table on it, right? And the placemats with the body parts, right? The little one looks at the placemat, he looks at me and he says, "Mama, where's your big penis?" I'm like, "It's in the top left-hand drawer, if you really must know." He is so cute. He is like the cutest kid you've ever seen. You know how like you would like one kid better? He is so cute. Oh my God, he says to me the other day, he goes, "Mama, when I grow up, if I have a little baby, does that mean you're going to be a grandma?" I'm like, "Yes, that's so cute, that's what it means." And then his older brother, who's a little bit of a smarty pants, like he refers to me as his birth mother, he says, "Mama, when I grow up, if I don't have a baby, does that mean you're just gonna be an old lady?" And I said, "Yes." And instinct tells me, with that level of charm, you're going to be my roommate. So, I went to a curriculum night at the school the other night where you meet the teachers, and the teachers have the kids write a little letter to the parents, so the parents have something waiting for them. And I wanted to share it with you on television. So cute, thank you for your support. Okay. So this is the letter. "Dear Mommy and Daddy, thanks for coming. I like PE. Love, Teddy." So sweet, right? And then they say to the parents, write a letter back. Write a letter back so the kids have something waiting for them when they get to school tomorrow. So this is the letter that I wrote back to Teddy. "Dear Teddy, I'd like to go to a spa for 4 to 6 weeks. But guilt and the cost of raising 2 children in New York City means that's never going to happen. Love, Mommy." They hate my cooking. My kids hate my cooking. I heard the little one say to the big one, "Even her noodles are bad." And the older son, the smarty pants, he's so honest. He says to me, "Mama, Grandma's a better cook than you. The only thing I like better that you make than what Grandma makes is soup. And that's because you make less of it." I'm like, "That's so interesting, because the only thing I like about you better than your little brother is your school day is longer." The little one has the opposite problem. He's like a liar. We were at a birthday party for his little friend. He'd eaten 2 cupcakes. He's a little chubby, fat, whatever. And he says to me, "May I have another cupcake?" And I said, no. And he says it again. May I have another cupcake? And I said, no. And then he turns to the mom of the kid. May I have another cupcake? She says, your mommy said no. And he goes, that's not my mommy. Oh my God, this woman here is so horrified. You in the black with the Jesus. You're like horrified. I can tell you don't have kids. She's like, but when you do, I promise you're gonna see. If you saw me with my kids, you would feel so much better. You would feel so much better. Because I'm always doing shit with them. I'm always saying I love you and all that shit. You know what I mean? But if you could read my mind, if you could see the transcript in my mind of everything I was thinking, this is what you would see. Shut up, 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 shut up. Please shut up, please, please, please shut up, please shut up, please, please. Would you shut the fuck up? Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up! Please! But you can't say anything. You can't say anything because they're gonna grow up and you need someone to help you with the computer. But I almost screwed up a couple of days ago. I almost screwed up. My kids ask a lot of questions, right? They ask crazy, crazy questions that make no sense. Mama, if you were to give birth to a crater, would you rather it be a girl crater or a boy crater? Mama, what if I ate a building? Mama, have you ever communicated with apes? Mama, how many dimes will fit in my room? Mama, when was the first time you ever smelled a banana? So I'm having a stroke. I'm having a stroke. There's no oxygen in my fucking head because the stupid fucking questions have effectively cut off the blood flow, right? And it's frozen here. It's frozen. There's nothing happening, right? There's nothing. There's parents over here. And then they ask a real question, right? A real one out of nowhere. Mama, what's a baby cow called? I'm like, a veal. And then I realized it had gone too far, so I wanted to fix it, right? You would have totally liked me at this point. Like, I wanted to fix it. I was like, I did my deep breath, so Oprah, right? I did my deep breath, and I go, honeybee, let's go 5 minutes. 5 minutes, please, with no questions. Why, Mama, why? Why no questions? Don't you love me? I love you. Why don't you love me? 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 Why I told my husband and told him this. He's like, now you know what it's like to have a wife. The men like that. The women are angry. Oh, you like it. No, you would totally like my, you would totally like my husband. He is so great. He went to France last week, and he does not speak a word of French. And I speak a little bit of French. And he texts me from the airplane, how do you say, you're hot? In French. So I text him back, j'ai herpes. I didn't find out the sex of the baby when I was pregnant because I was like, hated being pregnant so much, right? It was the only fun thing. I figure once you find out the sex of the baby, why continue with the pregnancy? And my mother-in-law almost ruined the whole thing for me. She said, I can tell you're going to have a baby girl. I'm like, wow, magic. How can you tell? And she said, because your bottom is so big. And I said, oh, are you having a baby girl too? You know, people on the birth announcement give you the exact, you know, they give you the exact weight of their baby, like I care, right? I want to know the weight of the mother. That's what interests me. Well, that's my time, everybody. Thank you so much. We'll be right back.
stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Anthony DeVito is taking the stage when we return.
Gentlemen, this man has the rad. Well, I'm sorry, I can't even read it. He has a podcast. He's gonna tell you about this off the chain. He goes by the name of Anthony DeVito. He has the Rad Drive podcast. Tell him about it. I'm sorry, Anthony DeVito.
Jesus. Jesus. Oh, man. So I'm at like an age where a lot of my friends are, they're pretty much married. Yeah, that's good for them. I don't know. People always talk about marriage being an institution. If that's true, it's Harvard. But, you know, not everybody belongs in an Ivy League school right away. Some people got to go to DeVry and transfer. So, okay. That's why there should be junior marriages. Cool, man. Yeah, I don't know, like, for people like me, like, the curriculum right now, it's just way too hard. Like, I gotta be there, love someone every day? For the rest of my life? Fuck you, that's crazy, that's insane. I'm not doing that. I don't know. You know. But I could do 2 days a week for 5 years online. And, you know, see if I like it. Amen. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. Hard to have confidence as a single man. Just when you take into account every other guy who's single, like George Clooney. He's single. That doesn't seem fair. That we're just allowed to hit on the exact same women. I mean, he lives in a multi-billion dollar home in Italy with no roommates. And I live in Queens with a guy named Mad Dog. Bubba's. But there's no law. He could come down to Starbucks, take away my favorite barista. He'd go to a bar, have anybody. He'd go to my house, take my mom away. Make a movie about it called Abducted by Love, and I'll go see him, be like, it's pretty good. He's a great actor. He's excellent in it. He's very good. It's fun. Yeah, I don't know. Being single should be more like sports, where you have clear, defined leagues. Like, you're 6'2", you make good money, you have health insurance. You really shouldn't be allowed to hit on the cashier at Target. Those are my people, and you stay off my land. That's what it is. This is, like, insane. Mike. Yeah, I don't know, movies, but, you know, too much bullshit, romance, movies. That's not like a great sentence, but, you know, it's like, whatever. Yeah, I probably should have done better with that one, you know what I mean? But no, like, I watched this movie. This couple, they overcame adversity. And then at the end of the movie, they looked in each other's eyes, and they were just like, love conquers all. But it's like, we only ever know that side of the story, where love is the good guy. What about I dated a girl in college for 4 years, then she cheated on me with my best friend, they started dating, now they're married. So I'm the thing love conquered. Yeah. Yeah. They don't make that movie.
No.
Yeah. I don't know. I just didn't know. Like, you don't know a person. I didn't know she was capable of that kind of evil. Like, you know? That's why you go on a first date with somebody, like, you shouldn't be like, hey, where are you from? Do you like pizza pies? You should be like, hey, what's the worst thing you're capable of doing to me? And, you know, this is too much. Hello. Hi. Hi. Yeah, just look him in the eye, you know what I mean? And just be like, would you steal our baby? Would you steal our baby? Would you do that? You do it first date, right at Applebee's. You get out of the way. And because then if they do that thing, you really can't get mad at them. You know? If someone's like, dude, she stole your baby, aren't you furious? I'd be like, not really. She told me that was a possibility. I could have walked away. Cameras, television, stuff. Yeah, the girl I'm seeing now, she's 8 years younger than me. She's 23, I'm 31. And a friend of mine made a big deal about it. And he was like, how do you relate to somebody in their early 20s? But he's white, he's dating an Asian girl. I don't know. It seems a lot harder to relate to. At least at some point in my life, I was 23. Yeah, right? Man. Yeah. Yeah, whoa. Crazy. Like, you know. If she was ever like, I don't know what I'm doing with my life, I'd be like, yeah, I remember that feeling. If she was ever like, I was on the subway, everybody thought I was a ninja, I'd be like, I don't know what to tell you. It's not happening to me. You guys are so nice. It's crazy. Oh, man. Yeah, it's not that old. I read the life expectancy in the Middle Ages was 28 years old. That's insane. They didn't know anything about the human body beyond 28. Like, they didn't know about menopause, your balls dropping, diarrhea farts. Like, they didn't know about any of that stuff. And, yeah. But that's the thing, we keep living longer and longer. There's gotta be stuff we don't know about yet, just because nobody's ever lived that long. Like, you know the dark brown spots that elderly people get on their skin as they get older? Yeah, like, what if those aren't old age spots? What if at some point all white people become black people? Like, maybe. I don't know. Scientists. This is crazy. Yeah. Like what, you know? What? What? What if everything just happens for a reason, you know? Like, you keep shrinking. That combines with the brown spots. 175. Everybody's a Mexican baby. Everybody. Maybe it's true. Science. Taco is a physicist. My friend is over there. Yeah, right. My mom, Joanne, she's a beautician. And she was talking to me because there's a lot of interracial couples on television now. And she was like, I don't know. I just think, you know, blacks should be with blacks, whites should be with whites. And I was like, that's pretty fucked up. Okay. And then she was like, no. Like, whoever you love, you love. That's a beautiful thing. It's just that black people, their hair is really tough. And then it's going to ruin our good hair, and I got to cut it. So that's where my mom's at. She's a hairdresser first, human being second. Yep. Down. Got it. Thanks. I don't know. Like, maybe more people are like that. We just write them off as hateful, but they just have, like, an occupational concern, you know? Where they're like, no, it's not that I hate gay people. I'm just a gynecologist, and it's bad for business. That's all. All right. All right, that's my time, man. You guys have been awesome. That's crazy.
Stay
tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Joe Larson is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs right now.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this next young man has a new CD called debut album. That's right, greatest hits. That's how good he is. He goes by the name of Joe Larson. Give it up for Joe.
Oh, thank you. Do I have some stories for you? I just went skydiving, which was awesome. I went tandem, where they strapped you to the dude, which wasn't my first choice. I wanted to go alone, but it turns out they don't let you go alone the first time because they figure you won't pull the chute in time, which is ridiculous. Plummeting to the earth at 125 miles an hour. I'm not the most punctual of people, but I'm going to be on time for that one. I don't think I'm going to be late for that appointment. I'll probably be early. I'll probably pull the chute in the plane. Just... I'm sorry. We're not even off the ground yet. No, I'm scared. I don't... We're still in the van. How'd you get a parachute? I chose tandem because when you go static, the other choice, you have to take an 8-hour class, and I went to community college, so that's out. Thank you. I didn't graduate because you don't. This community college isn't really college. It's more a holding place until your parents realize maybe we didn't birth a winner. Don't clap too hard, NYU. Calm down. All excited over there. Oh, burn! Have fun paying off those loans. Thank you. I have the ADD as well. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the ADD, which don't feel bad for me. If you're going to have a three-letter disease, that is the one you want. I have the ADD and the depression, which is good. If you're gonna have one, have both, because every time I go to kill myself, I get distracted. Just, you know. It's not hunting season. I live in Brooklyn with my girlfriend. That's right, I have a girlfriend. We're in a pretty serious relationship. We are married. Yeah. I think this might be the one. You never know. It's a big commitment, marriage. My wife is awesome. She is a doctor, so laugh. Don't laugh. I don't care. I don't need your money. I'm not paying rent. Come on. My wife proposed to me, which is a little non-traditional. She did. She ended up proposing to me. It was incredibly romantic. She came up to me one night, and she was like, I'm pregnant. I was like, oh. I do. I never thought you'd ask. Marriage is difficult. I just found out my parents are getting divorced at the age of 60, which at first is very sad, and then it's absolutely hilarious. Because when you get divorced at 25 or 35, it's like, you know what? Maybe we got married too young. Maybe we should go our own ways and live the lives we were meant to live. Be truly happy. When you get divorced at 60, it's like, I'd rather die alone. So we had a baby, my wife and I had a baby 2 years ago. We had a girl, and thank you. We wanted a boy. So we are raising her gay. That's the birth words. Fear, that's all. We were just afraid to have a girl, because you got to worry about a girl. You got to worry about a girl, and not even for the girl. You got to worry about a girl because of creepy dudes. There's creepy dudes everywhere. We've seen some on the stage tonight. There's creepy dudes everywhere that want to do creepy things to your beautiful daughter. So my wife and I, we've talked it over. We've come up with a plan to keep our daughter safe. We're not going to potty train her. Ever. Guess who's coming home early from the prom? The girl just took a deuce in her dungarees. That's Sue, safety first. Discipline's a big question. How are you going to discipline the kid we've decided we're not going to hit? We don't believe violence is the answer. We're just going to talk to them, right? They're human beings. You can reason with them. You just got to say things to them like, listen, you used to have a brother. You know, understanding and compassion, it's very important. They're like, I'm not cleaning her room. Say, that's what Kevin said. Religion was another big question for us. My wife and I come from different religions. My wife was raised Catholic. I was thinking about becoming Catholic for a while, which, I mean, I know you can't just become Catholic. You know, it's something you have to be molested into. So I decided against I'm very tired, I guess. I'm very tired. If you have a kid, you know the kind of tired I'm talking about. If you don't have a kid, you think you know the kind of tired I'm talking about, but you fucking don't. My mom called me up like a month in. She was like, can you even imagine your life without her?
Yeah.
Babies wake up every 2 hours to eat. I don't know if you know that, single people. Babies wake up every 2 hours to eat. And you can't be like, chili's in the fridge. I'm going back to bed. You have to feed them. You have to feed them, which takes a half hour. Then you have to burp them, which takes a half hour. Then you have to try to put them back to sleep, which takes another half hour. And then a half hour later, guess what? They're up again. Which means you get to sleep 20 minutes of every 2 hours. Which means if you wanted to sleep a full 8 hours in a 24-hour period, you would have to try to sleep every second of the day that you're not burping, feeding, or trying to put that child to sleep. That information should be on the outside of every box of condoms as an advertisement. I'm not afraid of STDs. I can get a good night's sleep with herpes, but a baby. Years ago, Magic Johnson got AIDS. You know what he's had every night since? A good night's sleep. I'm just saying. Grass is always greener. I've learned a few things living with my wife. I learned this. Apparently, when you live with a woman, whenever you hear the word my, it's always followed by stuff or things. And whenever you hear the word your, it's always followed by shit or crap. Just... My wife's on the place be ours, we're moving in. She kept telling me that. That was her little joke. I want you to feel like this is ours together. I don't want you to feel like it's your place or like it's my place anymore. I want you to feel like it's both of our, don't touch that. Like it's both of our place. I didn't have to propose because I knocked her up, which is a pretty sweet deal, right? Because as we all know, proposing is giving up. If you don't think proposing is giving up, look at any sport where a man has to give up. He has to do the exact same physical action. Football, guy kicks off, receiver catches the ball, he's deep in the end zone. Other teams all around him, there's no possibility he can move down the field whatsoever. If he even tries, he's going to be beaten into the ground. He has to give up, so what does he do? He drops down to one knee. In boxing, when a man has been punched in the face so many times that he can no longer continue fight for even his own life. It's the middle of the round, he wants to give up. What does he do? He drops down to one knee. And when a man has dated a woman for so long that he can no longer dress himself or speak on his own behalf. It's a nice sweater combo you got there, boss. He comes to this realization, he says, you know what? It's time to give up. So what does he do? He drops down to one knee. He says, I love you. Here's your championship ring. Thanks so much, you guys.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, James Smith is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you see this man on Comedy Central. He's funny. He goes by the name of James Smith. Bye.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. I have this inner voice in my head which keeps me very accountable, right? So if I'm in the street and I see a beautiful woman and I'm like, oh, I would do anything. And the voice kicks in. It's like, really? What would you do? Would you go to the gym? Would you get a job? No, you wouldn't, would you? So you wouldn't do anything to be with her. You just want a miracle. Or you wish she was blind. It's a good point in a voice, well made. I guess if the woman said, look, do those things and I will go out with you, I would work towards them as a goal. But I refuse to do it on spec. I'm not walking around the city all jacked with a great job just in case. Too risky. I don't know. I'm trying to understand life, right? And I'm learning one mistake at a time. I've learned this. You have to date people that you really like, right? It's got to be a comprehensive attraction. It can't just be physical, because if it is, it's doomed, because men are bipolar when it comes to sex, right? Pre and post sex, two different people, right? Pre-sex, very enthusiastic, right? Yes, I agree with that. Ha, 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 that's so funny. Just the lies, the deception, you know? I hear myself on dates, I'm like, shut the fuck up, Jesus Christ. And it's all just to get laid, right? But the minute that you climax, you're like, what have I done? It's like a murder. There's a naked body here. How do I get rid of it? I have left my own apartment after sex. I don't even care if they rob me, I just can't be there. And I don't know why that is. I don't know what happens, you know? Something changes in a man during orgasm. Something leaves the body. I don't know. I think it's interest. I think interest. Because women are so comfortable, right? They're like, what do you want to do now? Anything not with you. I'll do anything you like, but you can't be there. I don't get it. I don't get it. And I adore women. I think they're phenomenal, right? I think the only evidence that you need that women are incredible is pregnancy, right? Just the fact that they agree to that. They're just like, yeah, sure. I'll let someone live inside me. for 9 months. 9 months. People say to me, can you hold this? I say, no. Abdomen. I don't think you couldn't explain pregnancy to a man. We couldn't digest it. You know, if you said, listen, here's what's going to happen. You got to have a child inside you for 9 months and then you got to squeeze it out your dick. There would be no more people, right? We would be extinct. Man would be like, I'd love to help, but that is outside my skill set. I'm not squeezing it out my dick. I don't know. I think a good measure of where society is at is when you watch porn, right? And I watch porn, but I don't enjoy it, right? It's like alcohol or chocolate. It's like, I shouldn't have done that, you know? But you kind of have to watch porn because it's kind of like sexual current affairs, you know? It's like, that's what's happening, right? But the women of porn are setting standards that regular women are never going to want to meet. I mean, they block their esophagus, right? They swallow the whole thing. Every day when I brush my teeth, right? I scrub my tongue, right? And almost every day, I go too far, right? And I get so frustrated with myself. I'm like, you know not to go that far, right? Because I throw up a little bit, right? And then I got to start again because I got vomit in my mouth. Right. I can only imagine what it must be like to have one of those enormous things lodged in your throat. And the way the women come up off it, they're like, oh, thank God I lived. Oh. Their eyes are watering and they're disorientated. Catching their breath. Is that necessary? You just have to suck it. You don't have to die. The risk-reward ratio. And the women are so subservient, they sit there, they're like, come on my face. No one wants you to come on their face. I don't like going outside in the rain. Let alone a face full of that. Have you ever tried to get it off? It's like concrete. They use it to make people. The one that mystifies me more than anything is anal sex. I don't get it. I watch the scene and it doesn't make any sense to me, right? It's illogical. Anal sex is the equivalent of driving your car the wrong way on the sidewalk. There's a perfectly good road right next to it. It takes cars.
I'm James Smith. I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City.
Oh, hey, that's right, ladies and gentlemen, this is a wrap up. Okay, stretch it out, that's right. Comics were funny as hell tonight, am I right? Damn! Now you gotta go outside, it's cold outside. How cold is it? Was it, it was 22 or something? 20 degrees, freezing outside. Gotta get the Yeah, too damn cold, you know it's cold. Gotta get that Starbucks, they put something in that Starbucks. They put something in that, people, don't drink that. People, Starbucks, let Starbucks open late. You know, Starbucks open at 6 a.m., let it open at 6:45. You know, people, you know, trying to break in like it's a dope house. I need a shirt. They put something in that shit. You ever go to Starbucks, people be sitting in there having conversations, no chair, sitting in there having conversations about an envelope. Really? Oh my God. I hate people who go in there and stay for like 3 hours. Can I drink my fucking coffee? You got your goddamn laptop and whole books and boxes. I'm sorry. Okay, let's bring up all our comics. Come on, all our comics. Yes. That's right. This is how we do it. Yo, man.
Anthony Devito.
Joe Larson.
James Smith.
I'm Mark Curry, and together we are the Knicks.